Happy Thursday, Firsties. We're going to continue with Judy Moody Mood Martian. And remember, she was in a really bad mood because her yarn got all messed up, but she couldn't stay in a bad mood. So instead of saying roar, she went meow. And then at school, somebody said something mean to her. And instead of roaring or stomping off, she just said sticks and stones. And was very calm about that. Leave it somewhere. And we're going to read on today to find out what happens next, because she invited everyone back to her house, including Jessica Finch. So my prediction, or my question to you, was what was your prediction? Why do you think she's going to invite them back to her house? She's already cleaned her room. She's made her smiley face pillow. I'm thinking maybe she's going to invite them back because she wants them to do homework with her, because even though she's trying to stay in a good mood, homework does not put Judy Moody into a good mood. So I'm thinking maybe she wants everybody to do homework together, and then she'll be forced to stay in a good mood. So we're going to read a little bit of the next chapter today called Nanu Nanu, and we'll finish it up tomorrow on Friday. All right, Nanu Nanu. Before Judy's friends got to her house, she shoved piles and piles of her lacy finger knitting chain into her closet and shut the door. This way her room would look neat and clean, a la Jessica Clean Room Finch. Now the only thing out of place was the tangled mangle of yarn made by Mouse. But thanks to her friends, that mess would be solved in no time. When everybody got to her house, they tried to guess what wild and crazy idea Judy had come up with this time. "I bet we're going to make the Eiffel Tower out of icing," said Amy. "I bet we're going to build a pyramid out of jello," said Frank. "I bet we're going to prank Stink with Judy's periscope," said Rocky. "Nothing like that," said Judy. "We're just glad you had one of your crazy ideas," said Rocky. "It means you're back." "Back from where?" "Never mind," said Rocky. "Just tell us what the thing is." Judy led them up the stairs. Her mood pillow was propped against the door, smiley face out. She flung open the door to her room. "Ta-da!" she called. Rocky froze. Frank gasped. Jessica blinked. Amy took off her glasses and put them back on, like she wasn't seeing right. Judy's room was as neat as a pin, but right smack dab in the middle of the floor was a giant puddle of yarn. A muddle of yarn. One big, humongous mess of tangled up yarn. "Welcome to Yarnapalooza," Judy said eagerly. "Yarnapalooza?" asked Jessica. "We're going to have a yarn party. Our mission, should we choose to accept the dare, which we will, is to untangle the yarn yeti." "This is your big idea?" Frank asked. "You're from another planet if you think this is fun," said Rocky. "Zzz," said Amy, pretending to snore. "I'll help," yelped Jessica Finch, picking up a thread of pink yarn. "Come on, you guys, it'll be fun, I promise," Judy told them. "About as much fun as watching socks dry," said Frank. "Then you guys think of an idea," said Judy. "In the meantime, Frank, hold out your arms." "Why me?" Frank asked as he held out his arms. Judy pulled out the big mess until she found an end. She started to wind the yarn around Frank's hands. She wrapped and wrapped the yarn in a circle. Green yarn turned into blue yarn, which turned into red yarn. "Can I put my hands down yet?" asked Frank. "My arms are killing me." "Not yet," said Judy. "Hey, did you guys know a ball of yarn is called a clue?" "So we're clueless?" asked Rocky. "Get a clue," said Judy. She cracked herself up. "Hey, I know. Let's play Clue," said Amy. "Or, I know, a level 3 spelling game we could play," said Jessica. Rocky flared his nose. "Count me out," he said. "Let's be detectives again." And here they are, trying to untangle that yarn. All right, let's see if this plan's going to work. Make a prediction. What do you think? Are they going to stick around for the yarn untangling? Or are they going to go, "I got to go home and do my own homework"? "We could solve a real life mystery," said Frank. "You know, like we did when that puppy, Mr. Chimps, went missing." "Great," said Judy. Her friend smiled and nodded, eager to hear what the mystery was going to be. "I have an idea." "Quiet, everybody," hissed Rocky. Judy's getting one of her brainstorms. Judy held a bright idea finger in the air. "Let's solve the mystery of how to untangle this blob of yarn." "Ah," said Rocky, "I thought it was going to be something big, something good." "Something scary," said Frank. "Something interesting," said Jessica. something not boring, said Amy. Or Judy said, we could play Jessica's level 3 game. I call yellow, said Rocky, diving for yellow yarn. Brown, said Frank, elbowing Rocky out of the way. Purple, called Judy. Pink, said Jessica, nudging Rocky. Everybody pushed and shoved, trying to get to their favorite color. Guess what? I know how to read colors, Amy told them when the ruckus died down. My mom has a whole book about it. What does brown mean? Asked Frank. It means you're weird, said Amy. All right, we're going to stop there. So Judy accomplished her plan. She got her friends to help her start to untangle that yarn. Now, make a new prediction. How do you think it's going to go? Do you think they'll get it all untangled? Do you think they're going to fight? Do you think Judy's going to stay in a good mood? Thumbs up if you think she's going to stay in a good mood. Thumbs down if you don't. I'm thinking this is good mood day number 3 going on right now, right? Or is she still good mood day number 2? What happens if they decide to quit? What do you think is going to happen to Judy's mood then? Okay, so stop and think. Then when you go to do your reading today, remember, think about what you read so far. Even if you have to whisper it back to yourself or go back and do a picture walk. And then make a prediction before you start reading what you think is going to happen next. And when you're finished, today's the last day in April, so I'm out of raindrops to color in, so I colored in a dot on my umbrella. So wherever you are on your April reading raindrop page, color one more thing in for today, and then on Monday, we'll start doing something different for May, because Friday, tomorrow, is going to be May 1st, all right? But it's still the last day of April, so you'll still be using that for today. I hope you have fun reading and making your predictions, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye, guys.